Did you know that a simple balloon can carry a camera to the very edge of space? In today's video, we are diving deep into the thrilling adventure of Balloon Stew, who sent his camera soaring beyond the stratosphere, capturing jaw-dropping footage that's captivated thousands. We'll answer your burning questions about this incredible journey, like the risks of colliding with aircraft, the mysteries of the Earth's curvature, and the true definition of space itself. But there's a twist. We'll also uncover some surprising truths and common misconceptions that many people have about high-altitude balloon flights. For example, did you know that while some skeptics claim the curvature of the Earth is just an optical illusion created by fisheye lenses, there's more to the story? Stick around until the end of the video, and we'll reveal something intriguing that no one seems to talk about: the unexpected challenges of retrieving a camera from the heights it reached. So, whether you're a science enthusiast, a curious skeptic, or just love exploring the mysteries of our world, you won't want to miss this. Let's unravel the secrets behind what happens when a balloon camera reaches space, because the answers might surprise you. The balloon and its journey into space. Let's start by revisiting the amazing footage Balloon Stew captured when he sent his balloon camera to the edge of space. If you watched the first video, you probably remember that magical moment when the balloon floated above the clouds, revealing the Earth's curvature and the vastness of space. But many of you had questions about how this all happened, and today we'll dive deep into the details. First off, one of the most common concerns people raised was about the potential danger of the balloon colliding with an airplane. And honestly, this is a valid question. Commercial airplanes typically fly between 30,000 and 40,000 feet, which is in the lower stratosphere. But Balloon Stew's balloon went much higher, over 100,000 feet, to the point where airplanes no longer fly. However, before launching, the team had to check for any possible flight routes and avoid restricted airspaces. The Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, requires anyone launching high-altitude balloons to file a Notice to Airmen, NOTAM. This ensures air traffic control is aware of the balloon and can reroute planes if necessary. So, while the danger might seem real, the process is heavily regulated to prevent any accidents. Debunking the fisheye lens curvature claim. Now, let's move on to another popular question from the first video. Was the curvature of the Earth faked by using a fisheye lens? This is a common argument made by skeptics who believe the footage is artificially distorted to make the Earth appear round. Fisheye lenses do indeed create a wide-angle effect that can exaggerate curves. But let's dive into the facts. Fisheye lenses are often used in such projects because they provide a wide field of view, capturing more of the surrounding environment, especially in a situation like a balloon rising into space. This distortion can cause the horizon to appear curved or exaggerated, even at lower altitudes. However, the actual curvature of the Earth does become visible at higher altitudes, even with minimal lens distortion. So while the fisheye effect is present, it does not necessarily negate the real curvature of the Earth seen in the footage. But here's the kicker. The curvature of the Earth is visible even at much lower altitudes, as low as 35,000 feet if you're flying on a plane. So seeing the curvature at over 100,000 feet is entirely consistent with what we already know. Plus, scientific research has proven for centuries that the Earth is round. The fisheye lens only enhances what's already there, but you know there's something even more fascinating about the way the curvature looks at high altitudes that we haven't discussed yet, and we'll talk about that soon. How far did the balloon travel? One question that caught our attention was, how far did you have to go to retrieve your camera? The answer to this might surprise you. After the balloon popped at around 100,000 feet, the camera didn't just come straight back down. High altitude winds caused it to drift a significant distance. During the flight, the balloon reached speeds of over 100 miles per hour due to high altitude jet streams. Thanks to our GPS tracker, we were able to pinpoint the landing site about 80 miles away from where we started. It was a bit of a journey to retrieve it, but the incredible footage made it worth it. Bloonstu had to rely on GPS tracking technology to locate the camera safely cushioned by a parachute. Without that technology, retrieving the camera would have been nearly impossible. Transcending the atmosphere. Another point that sparked a lot of debate was, can a balloon truly transcend the atmosphere? Some viewers suggested that a balloon floats within the atmosphere and never truly enters space. To answer this, we need to clarify what we mean by space and where the atmosphere ends. Earth's atmosphere is divided into several layers: the troposphere, the stratosphere, the mesosphere, and the thermosphere. The balloon launched by Bloonstu traveled through the stratosphere and reached what is called the near space region. This is a term used to describe altitudes between 50,000 and 330,000 feet. So technically, the balloon didn't make it to outer space, which starts at the Kármán line. 62 miles or 330,000 feet above sea level. But it did ascend into what's often called the edge of space, where the atmosphere becomes extremely thin and the sky turns black. The term space is often used loosely here, but make no mistake, at over 100,000 feet, the view is otherworldly. Signal and camera recovery. How did it work? Some of you were skeptical about how Bloonstu managed to maintain a signal connection with the camera for the entire flight. This is another great question, and the answer lies in the type of technology used. The camera was equipped with a GPS tracker and a radio transmitter that sent data back to Earth in real time. High-altitude balloons often use specialized radios that can maintain communication over long distances, even at extreme altitudes. And while the balloon did travel far away, the signal was strong enough to be picked up for most of the flight. Once the balloon burst and began descending, the GPS tracker helped pinpoint its landing location. Now, some of you might wonder, on a spinning globe, shouldn't the camera have landed hundreds of miles away? Well, the answer lies in the speed of the Earth's rotation. While it's true the Earth spins at around 1,000 miles per hour, both the balloon and the atmosphere are rotating with it. The balloon is essentially stuck within the atmosphere, so it's carried along with the Earth's rotation. This means it doesn't drift as far as you might think. There's a hidden challenge with maintaining signal at these heights, though, and we'll get into that later. Where are the stars? A popular question that many people asked was, where are the stars? This is a fascinating point. When we imagine space, we often think of a black sky filled with twinkling stars. But in the footage captured by Bloonstu, the sky is black, yet there are no stars visible. Why is that? The reason has to do with exposure. The camera's settings were optimized for capturing the bright Earth and the faint horizon. At such high altitudes, the contrast between the bright Earth and the much dimmer stars is extreme. Cameras need a longer exposure time to capture starlight properly. But in this case, the exposure was set for the near-Earth environment. That's why the stars don't appear, even though they were there. If you've ever tried to photograph stars with a regular camera, you know how tricky it can be. In space, this effect is amplified. Airspace permission. Is it needed? One viewer asked, did you need permission from aerospace authorities to ensure a clear path? This is a great question, and it shows just how complex launching a high-altitude balloon can be. Yes. Bloonstu did need to get permission to launch the balloon. As mentioned earlier, filing a notice to airmen, NOTAM, is a legal requirement in most countries, including the US, for flights like these. The FAA monitors all air traffic, and the NOTAM helps ensure that the balloon doesn't interfere with commercial planes or other aircraft. But beyond that, Bloonstu also had to monitor the weather and wind conditions to make sure the balloon would follow a safe path during its ascent. Interestingly, balloons like this have been used by researchers for decades, and there's a lot of regulations in place to keep both the balloon and other air traffic safe. But there's a side of this process that most people aren't aware of, and we'll talk about that soon. Mysteries of the atmosphere extending beyond the moon. Some viewers raised the fascinating point that the atmosphere extends beyond the moon, which contradicts what we usually hear. While it sounds like science fiction, there's some truth to this. Scientists have discovered that Earth's exosphere, the outermost layer of the atmosphere, extends far beyond what we traditionally think. It stretches up to 390,000 miles, which is beyond the moon's orbit. However, this part of the atmosphere is so thin that it's nearly indistinguishable from the vacuum of space. So, while it's true that Earth's atmosphere technically extends that far, it's not in the way we normally imagine. But you know what's even more surprising? The presence of space debris in the lower parts of the atmosphere, which we'll discuss shortly. Why no space junk? Another keen observation from viewers. Why wasn't there any space junk, satellites, or other objects visible in the footage? After all, with thousands of satellites orbiting the Earth, you'd think they would show up in the video, right? The reason is simple. Altitude. Most satellites orbit much higher than the 100,000-foot Bloonstu's balloon reached. Even the International Space Station orbits at around 250 miles, 400 kilometers, above the Earth's surface. This means that while the balloon reached impressive heights, it was still far below the majority of orbiting satellites and space junk. Space is a big place, and even with all the objects humans have put into orbit, they're still spread out over vast distances. By now, we've answered some of your most pressing questions about Bloonstu's balloon journey, from the safety concerns surrounding airplanes to the mysteries of Earth's curvature, and even the complexities of signal transmission and star visibility. Yet, there's still more to uncover about what happens when a balloon camera reaches the edge of space. Thanks for watching, everyone. We're always looking to improve and provide the best content for our viewers, so we appreciate your feedback. If you enjoyed diving into the science and mystery behind balloon flights to near space, make sure to hit that like button. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more amazing content like this. If you have any more questions or thoughts, drop them in the comments below. We love hearing from you. And of course, click the notification bell so you never miss an update. Stay curious, and we'll see you on the next adventure.